A Shropshire Lad. 1. 1887. From Clee to heaven the beacon burns, the shires have seen it plain. From north and south the sign returns, and beacons burn again. Look left, look right, the hills are bright, the dales are light between. Because 'tis 50 years tonight that God has saved the Queen. Now, when the flame they watched not towers about the soil they trod, lads will remember friends of ours who shared the work with God. To skies that knit their heartstrings right, to fields that bred them brave, the saviours come not home tonight, themselves they could not save. It dawns in Asia, tombstones show, and Shropshire names are read, and the Nile spills his overflow beside the Severn's dead. We pledge in peace by farm and town the Queen they served in war, and fire the beacons up and down the land they perished for. God save the Queen, we living sing, from height to height 'tis heard, and with the rest of your voices ring, lads of the 53rd. O God will save her, fear you not, be you the men you've been. Get you the sons your father's got, and God will save the Queen. 2. Loveliest of the trees, the cherry now is hung with bloom along the bough, and stands about the woodland ride wearing white for Eastertide. Now of my 80 years and 10, 20 will not come again, and take from 70 springs a score, it only leaves me 54. And since to look at things in bloom, 50 springs are little room, about the woodlands I will go to see the cherry hung with snow. 3. The Recruit. Leave your home behind, lad, and reach your friends your hand, and go, and luck go with you, while Ludlow Tower shall stand. Oh, come you home of Sunday, when Ludlow streets are still, and Ludlow bells are calling to farm and lane and mill. Or come you home of Monday, when Ludlow market hums, and Ludlow chimes are playing, the conquering hero comes. Come you home a hero, or come not home at all, the lads you leave will mind you till Ludlow Tower shall fall. And you will list the bugle that blows in lands of morn, and make the foes of England be sorry you were born. And you till trump of doomsday on lands of morn may lie, and make the hearts of comrades be heavy where you die. Leave your home behind you, your friends by field and town. O town and field will mind you till Ludlow Tower is down. 4. Wake. The silver dusk returning up the beach of darkness brims, and the ship of sunrise burning strands upon the eastern rims. Wake. The vaulted shadow shatters, trampled to the floor it spanned, and the tent of night in tatters straws the sky-pavilioned land. Up, lad, up! 'Tis late for lying. Hear the drums of morning playing. Hark! The empty highways crying. Hill beyond the hills away. Towns and countries woo together. Foreland's beacon, belfry's call. Never lad that trod on leather lived to feast his heart with all. Up, lad! Those that lie and cumber sunlit pallets never thrive. Morn's abed and daylight slumber were not meant for man alive. Clay lies still, but blood's a rover, breath's a ware that will not keep. Up, lad! When the journey's over, there'll be time enough to sleep. 5. Oh, see how thick the gold cup flowers are lying in field and lane, with dandelions to tell the hours that never are told again. Oh, may I squire you round the meads and pick your posies gay? 'Twill do no harm to take my arm. You may, young man, you may. Ah, spring was sent for lass and lad. 'Tis now the blood runs gold, and man and maid had best be glad before the world is old. What flowers today may flower tomorrow, but never as good as new. Suppose I wound my arm right round. 'Tis true, young man, 'tis true. Some lads there are, 'tis shame to say, that only court to thieve, and once they bear the bloom away, 'tis little enough they leave. Then keep your heart for men like me, and safe from trustless chaps. My love is true, and all for you, perhaps, young man, perhaps. Oh, look in my eyes then, can't you doubt? Why, 'tis a mile from town, and how green the grass is all about. We might as well sit down. Ah, life, what is it but a flower? Why must true lovers sigh? Be kind, have pity, my own, my pretty. Goodbye, young man, goodbye. 6. When the lad for longing sighs, mute and dull of cheer and pale, if at death's own door he lies, maiden, you can heal his ail. Lover's ills are all to buy, the wan look, the hollow tone, the hung head, the sunken eye, you can leave them for your own. Buy them, even mourn, lover's ills are all to sell, then you can lie down forlorn, but the lover will be well. 7. When smoke stood up from Ludlow, and mist blew off from Team, and blithe the field to ploughing against the morning beam, I strode beyond my team. The blackbird in the coppice looked out to see me stride, and heartened as I whistled the trampling team beside, and fluted and replied, lie down, young yeoman. What use to rise and rise? Rise man a thousand mornings, yet down at last he lies, and then the man is wise. I heard the tune he sang me, and spied his yellow bill. I picked a stone and aimed it, and threw it with a will. Then the bird was still. Then my soul within me took up the blackbird's strain, and still beside the horses, along the dewy lane, it sang the song again. Lie down, young yeoman, the sun moves always west, the road one treads to labour will lead one home to rest, and that will be the best. 8. Farewell to barn and stack and tree, farewell to Severn Shore. Terence, look your last at me, for I come home no more. The sun burns on the half-mown hill, by now the blood is dried, and Morris amongst the hay lies still, and my knife is in his side. My mother thinks us long away, 'tis time the field were mown. She had two sons at rising day, tonight she'll be alone. And here's a bloody hand to shake, and oh, man, here's goodbye. We'll sweat no more on scythe and rake, my bloody hands and I. I wish you strength to bring you pride, and a love to keep you clean, and I wish you luck, come Lammenstein, at racing on the green. Long for me the rick will wait, and long will wait the fold, and long will stand the empty plate, and dinner will be cold. 9. On moonlit heath and lonesome bank the sheep beside me graze, and yon the gallows used to clank fast by the four cross ways. A careless shepherd once would keep the flocks by moonlight there, and high amongst the glimmering sheep the dead man stood on air. They hang us now in Shrewsbury jail, the whistles blow forlorn, and trains all night groan on the rail to men that die at morn. Or wakes as may betide, a better lad, if things went right, than most that sleep outside. And naked to the hangman's noose, the morning clocks will ring, a neck God made for other use than strangling in a string. And sharp the link of life will snap, and dead on air will stand, heels that held up as straight a chap as treads upon the land. So here I'll watch the night and wait to see the morning shine, when he will hear the stroke of 8 and not the stroke of 9. And wish my friend as sound asleep as lads I did not know that shepherded the moonlit sheep 100 years ago. 10. March. The sun at noon to higher air, unharnessing the silver pair, that late before his chariot swam, rides on the gold wool of the ram. So braver notes the storm cock sings, to start the rusted wheel of things, and brutes in field and brutes in pen, leap the world goes round again. The boys are up in the woods with day to fetch the daffodils away, and home at noonday from the hills they bring no dearth of daffodils. A field for palms the girls repair, and sure enough the palms are there, and each will find by hedge or pond her waving silver tufted wand. In farm and field through all the shire, the eye beholds the heart's desire, and let not only mine be vain, for lovers should be loved again. 11. On your midnight pallet lying, listen and undo the door. Lads that waste the light in sighing, in the dark should sigh no more. Night should ease a lover's sorrow, therefore since I go tomorrow, pity me before. In the land to which I travel, the far dwelling, let me say, once if here the couch is gravel, in a kinder bed I lay, and the breast the darnel smothers, rested once upon another's, when it was not clay. 12. When I watch the living meet, and the moving pageant file, warm and breathing through the street, where I lodge a little while, if the heats of hate and lust in the house of flesh are strong, let me mind the house of dust, where my sojourn shall be long. In the nation that is not, nothing stands that stood before. Their revenges are forgot, and the hater hates no more. Lovers lying two and two, ask not whom they sleep beside, and the bridegroom all night through never turns him to the bride. 13. When I was 21, I heard a wise man say, give crowns and pounds and guineas, but not your heart away. Give pearls away and rubies, but keep your fancy free. But I was 21, no one used to talk to me. When I was 21, I heard him say again, 'Tis heart out of the bosom, was never given in vain. 'Tis paid with sighs a plenty, and sold for endless rue. And I am 22, and oh, 'tis true, 'tis true. 14. There pass the careless people that call their souls their own. Here by the road I loiter, how idle and alone. Ah, past the plunge of plummet, in seas I cannot sound, my heart and soul and senses, world without end, are drowned. His folly has no fellow, beneath the blue of day, that gives to man or woman his heart and soul away. There flowers no balm to sain him, from east of earth to west, that's lost for everlasting, the heart out of his breast. Here by the labouring highway, with empty hands I stroll, sea deep till doomsday morning, lie lost my heart and soul. 15. Look not in my eyes for fear, they mirror true the sight I see, and there you find your face too clear, and love it and be lost like me. One the long nights through must lie, spent in star-defeated sighs, but why should you as well as I perish? Gaze not in my eyes. A Grecian lad, as I here tell, one that many loved in vain, looked into a forest well, and never looked away again. There, when the turf in springtime flowers, with downward eye and gazes sad, stands amid the glancing showers, a jonquil, not a Grecian lad. 16. It nods and curtsies and recovers when the wind blows above the nettle on the graves of lovers that hanged themselves for love. The nettle nods, the wind blows over, the man he does not move, the lover of the grave, the lover that hanged himself for love. 17. Twice a week the winter thorough, here stood I to keep the goal. Football then was fighting sorrow for the man's young soul. Now in Maytime to the wicket, out I march with bat and pad, see the son of grief at cricket, trying to be glad. Try I will, no harm in trying, wonder 'tis how little mirth keeps the bones of man from lying on the bed of earth. 18. Oh, when I was in love with you, then I was clean and brave, and miles around the wonder grew, how well I did behave. And now the fancy passes by, and nothing will remain, and miles around me they'll say that I am quite myself again. 19. To an athlete dying young. The time you won your town the race, we cheered you through the marketplace. Man and boy stood cheering by, and home we brought you shoulder high. Today the road all runners come, shoulder high we bring you home, and set you at your threshold down, townsman of a stiller town. Smart lad, to slip betimes away from fields where glory does not stay, and early though the laurel grows, it withers quicker than the rose. Eyes the shady night has shut cannot see the record cut, and silence sounds no worse than cheers after earth has stopped the ears. Now you will not swell the rout of lads that wore their honours out, runners whom renown outran, and the name died before the man. So set, before its echoes fade, the fleet foot on the sill of shade, and hold to the low lintel up the still-defended challenge cup. And round that early laurelled head will flock to gaze the strengthless dead, and find unwithered on its curls the garland briefer than a girl's. 20. Oh, fair enough are sky and plain, but I know fairer far. Those are as beautiful again that in the water are. The pools and rivers wash so clear, the trees and clouds and air, the like on earth was never seen, and oh, that I were there. These are the thoughts I often think as I stand gazing down, in act upon the cressy brink to strip and dive and drown. But in the golden sanded brooks and azure meres I spy a silly lad that longs and looks and wishes he were I. 21. Bredon Hill. In summertime on Bredon the bells they sound so clear, round both the shires they ring them, in steeples far and near, a happy noise to hear. Here of a Sunday morning my love and I would lie, and see the coloured counties, and hear the larks so high, about us in the sky. The bells would ring to call her, in valleys miles away, come all to church, good people, come and pray. But here my love would stay, and I would turn and answer among the springing time, oh, peal upon our wedding, and we will hear the chime, and come to church in time. But when the snows at Christmas on Bredon top were strown, my love rose up so early, and stole out unbeknown, and went to church alone. They tolled the one bell only, groom there was none to see, the mourners followed after, and so to church went she, and would not wait for me. The bells they sound on Bredon, and still the steeples hum. Come all to church, good people, O noisy bells, be dumb. I hear you, I will come. 22. The street sounds to the soldiers' tread, and out we troop to see. A single redcoat turns his head, he turns and looks at me. My man, from sky to sky so far, we never crossed before. Such leagues apart the world's ends are, we're like to meet no more. What thoughts at heart of you and I, we cannot stop to tell, but dead or living, drunk or dry, soldier, I wish you well. 23. The lads in their hundreds to Ludlow come in for the fair. There's men from the barn and the forge and the mill and the fold. The lads for the girls and the lads for the liquor are there. And there with the rest are the lads that will never be old. There's chaps from the town and the field and the till and the cart, and many to count are the stalwart and many the brave, and many the handsome of face and handsome of heart, and few that will carry their looks or truth to the grave. I wish one could tell them, I wish there were tokens to tell, the fortunate fellows that now you can never discern, and then one could talk with them friendly and wish them farewell, and watch them depart on the way they will not return. But now you may stare as you like, and there's nothing to scan, and brushing your elbow unguessed at and not to be told, they carry back bright to the coiner the mintage of man, the lads that will die in their glory and never be old. 24. Say, lad, have you things to do? Quick then, while your day's at prime, quick, and if it's 'tis work for two, here I am, man, now's your time. Send me now, and I shall go, call me, I shall hear you call, use me ere they lay me low, where a man's no use at all. Ere the wholesome flesh decay, and the willing nerve be numb, and the lips lack breath to say, no, my lad, I cannot come. 25. This time of year a 12-month passed when Fred and I would meet. We needs must jangle till at last we fought and I was beat. So then the summer fields about till rainy days began. Rose Harland on her Sundays out walked with the better man. The better man she walks with still, though now 'tis not with Fred. A lad that lives and has his will is worth a dozen dead. Fred keeps the house all kinds of weather, and clays the house he keeps. When Rose and I walk out together, stock still lies Fred and sleeps. 26. Along the field as we come by, a year ago, my love and I, the aspen over stile and stone was talking to itself alone. Oh, who are these that kiss and pass, a country lover and his lass, two lovers looking to be wed, and time shall put them both to bed. But she shall lie with earth above, and he beside another love. And sure enough, beneath the tree, there walks another love with me. And overhead the aspen heaves its rainy-sounding silver leaves, and I spell nothing in the stir. But now perhaps they speak to her, and plain for her to understand, they talk about a time at hand when I shall sleep with clover clad, and she beside another lad. 27. Is my ploughing team that I used to drive and hear the harness jingle when I was man alive? Ay, the horses trample, the harness jingles now, no change though you lie under the land you used to plough. Is football playing along the river shore with lads to chase the leather, now I stand up no more? Aye, the ball is flying, the lads play heart and soul, the goal stands up, the keeper stands up to keep the goal. Is my girl happy? That I thought hard to leave, and has she tried of weeping as she lies down at eve? Aye, she lies down lightly, she lies not down to weep, your girl is well contented, be still my lad and sleep. Is my friend hearty, now I am thin and pine, and has he found to sleep a better bed than mine? Yes, lad, I lie easy, I lie as lads would choose, I cheer a dead man's sweetheart, never ask me whose. 28. The Welsh Marches. High the vanes of Shrewsbury gleam, islanded in Severn stream, the bridges from the steepled crest cross the water east and west. The flag of morn in conqueror's state enters at the English gate. The vanquished eve, as night prevails, bleeds upon the road to Wales. Ages since the vanquished bled round my mother's marriage bed. There the ravens feasted far about the open house of war. When Severn down to Buildwas ran, coloured with the death of man, couched upon her brother's grave, the Saxon got me on the slave. The sound of fight is silent long, that began the ancient wrong. Long the voice of tears is still, that wept of old the endless ill. In my heart it has not died, the war that sleeps on Severn's side. They cease not fighting east and west, on the marches of my breast. Here the truceless armies yet trample, rolled in blood and sweat. They kill and kill and never die, and I think that each is I. None will part us, none undo the knot that makes one flesh of two, sick with hatred, sick with pain, strangling. When shall we be slain? When shall I be dead and rid of the wrong my father did? How long till spade and hearse put to sleep my mother's curse? 29. The Lent Lily. 'Tis spring, come out to ramble, the hilly brakes around, for under thorn and bramble, about the hollow ground, the primroses are found. And there's the windflower chilly, with all the winds at play, and there's the Lenten Lily, that has not long to stay, and dies on Easter Day. And since till girls go maying, you find the primrose still, and find the windflower playing, with every wind at will. But not the daffodil. Bring baskets now and sally upon the spring's array, and bear from hill and valley the daffodil away that dies on Easter Day. 30. Others, I am not the first, have willed more mischief than they durst. If in the breathless night I too shiver now, 'tis nothing new. More than I, if truth were told, have stood and sweated hot and cold, and through their rain in ice and fire, fear contented with desire. Argued once like me were they, but I like them shall win my way, lastly to the bed of mould, but there's neither heat nor cold. But from my grave across my brow plays no wind of healing now, and fire and ice within me fight beneath the suffocating night. 31. On Wenlock Edge the wood's in trouble, his forest fleece the reeking heaves, the gale it plies the saplings double, and thick on Severn snow the leaves. 'Twould blow like this through holt and hanger, when Uricon the city stood. 'Tis the old wind in the old anger, but then it threshed another wood. Then, 'twas before my time, the Roman at yonder heaving hill would stare. The blood that warms an English yeoman, the thoughts that hurt him that were not there. There, like the wind through the woods in riot, through him the gale of life blew high. The tree of man was never quiet, then 'twas the Roman, now 'tis I. The gale it plies the saplings double, it blows so hard 'twill soon be gone. Today the Roman and his trouble are ashes under Uricon. 32. From far, from even morning, and yon 12 winded sky, the stuff of life to knit me blew hither, here am I. Now, for a breath I tarry, nor yet disperse apart, take my hand quick and tell me, what have you in your heart? Speak now and I will answer, how shall I help you say, ere the wind's 12 quarters I take my endless way. 33. If truth in hearts that perish could move the powers on high, I think the love I bear you should make you not to die. Sure, sure, if steadfast meaning, if single thought could save, the world might end tomorrow, you should not see the grave. This long and sure-set liking, this boundless will to please, oh, you should live forever, if there were help in these. But now, since all is idle, to this lost heart be kind, ere to a town you journey, where friends are ill to find. 34. The New Mistress. Oh, sick I am to see you, will you never let me be? You may be good for something, but you're not good for me. Oh, go where you are wanted, for you're not wanted here. And that was all the farewell when I parted from my dear. I will go where I am wanted to a lady born and bred, who will dress me free for nothing in a uniform of red. She will not be sick to see me, if I only keep it clean. I will go where I am wanted, for a soldier of the Queen. I will go where I am wanted, for the sergeant does not mind. He may be sick to see me, but he treats me very kind. He gives me beer and breakfast, and a ribbon for my cap, and I never knew a sweetheart spend her money on a chap. I will go where I am wanted, where there's room for one or two, and the men are none too many for the work there is to do. Where the standing line wears thinner, and the dropping dead lies thick, and the enemies of England, they shall see me and be sick. 35. On the idle hill of summer, sleepy with the flow of streams, far I hear the steady drummer, drumming like a noise in dreams. Far and near and low and louder, on the roads of earth go by, dear to friends and food for powder, soldiers marching, all to die. East and west on fields forgotten, bleach the bones of comrades slain, lovely lads and dead and rotten, none that go return again. Far the calling bugles hollow, high the screaming fife replies, gay the files of scarlet follow, woman bore me, I will rise. 36. White in the moon the long road lies, the moon stands blank above. White in the moon the long road lies, that leads me from my love. Still hangs the hedge without a gust, still, still the shadows stay. My feet upon the moonlit dust, pursue the ceaseless way. The world is round, so travellers tell, and straight though reach the track. Trudge on, 'twill all be well, the way will guide one back. But ere the circle homeward hies, far, far must it remove. White in the moon the long road lies, that leads me from my love. 37. As though the wild green hills of Wyre, the train ran, changing sky and shire, and far behind a fading crest, low in the forsaken west, sank the high-reared head of Clee. My hand lay empty on my knee, aching on my knee it lay. That morning half a shire away, so many an honest fellow's fist had well nigh wrung it from the wrist. Hand, said I, since we now part from fields and men we know by heart, for strangers' faces, strangers' lands, hand, you have held true fellows' hands. Be clean then, rot before you do, a thing they'd not believe of you. You and I must keep from shame, in London streets the Shropshire name. On banks of Thames they must not say, seven breeds worse men than they. And friends abroad must bear in mind, friends at home they leave behind. Oh, I shall be stiff and cold when I forget you, hearts of gold. The land where I shall mind you not is the land where all's forgot. And if my foot returns no more to Teme nor Corve nor Severn shore, luck, my lads, be with you still, by falling stream and standing hill, by chiming tower and whispering tree, men that made a man of me. About your work in town and farm, still you'll keep my head from harm, still you'll help me, hands that gave a grasp to friend me to the grave. 38. The winds out of the west land blow, my friends have breathed them there, warm with the blood of lads I know, comes east the sighing air. It fanned their temples, filled their lungs, scattered their forelocks free. My friends made words of it with tongues that talk no more to me. Their voices dying as they fly, loose on the wind are sown. The names of men blow soundless by, my fellows and my own. Oh, lads, at home I hear you plain, but here your speech is still, and down the sighing wind in vain, you hollow from the hill. The wind and I, we both were there, but neither long abode, and through the friendless world we fare, and sigh upon the road. 39. 'Tis time, I think, by Wenlock town, the golden broom should blow, the hawthorn sprinkled up and down, should charge the land with snow. Spring will not wait the loiterer's time, who keeps so long away, so others wear the broom and climb the hedgerows heaped with may. O tarnish late on Wenlock edge, gold that I never see, lie long high snowdrifts in the hedge that will not shower on me. 40. Into my heart an air that kills from yon far country blows. What are those blue remembered hills? What spires, what farms are those? That is the land of lost content. I see it shining plain, the happy highways where I went and cannot come again. 41. In my own shire, if I was sad, homely comforters I had. The earth, because my heart was sore, sorrowed for the son she bore, and standing hills long to remain, shared their short-lived comrade's pain, and bound for the same bourne as I, on every road I wandered by. Trod beside me close and dear, the beautiful and death-struck year, whether in the woodland brown, I heard the beech-nut rustle down, and saw the purple crocus pale, flower about the autumn dale, or littering far the fields of May, lady smocks a-bleaching lay. And like a sky-lit water stood the bluebells in the azured wood. Yonder lightning other loads, the seasons range the country roads, but here in London streets I ken no such helpmates, only men. And these are not in plight to bear, if they would, another's care. They have enough, as 'tis. I see, in many an eye that measures me, the mortal sickness of a mind too unhappy to be kind. And done with misery, all they can is hate their fellow man. Until they drop, they needs must still look at you and wish you ill. 42.
Once in the wind of morning, I ranged the thymy wold. The world-wide air was azure, and all the brooks ran gold. There through the dews beside me, behold a youth that trod, with feathered cap on forehead, and poised a golden rod. With mind to match the morning, and gay delightful guise, and friendly brows and laughter, he looked me in the eyes. Oh, whence, I asked, and whither? He smiled and would not say, and looked at me and beckoned, and laughed and led the way. And with kind looks and laughter, and naught to say beside, we two went on together, I and my happy guide. Across the glittering pastures, and empty uplands still, and solitude of shepherds, high in the folded hill. By hanging woods and hamlets that gaze through orchards down, on many a windmill turning and far discovered town, with gay regards of promise and sure and slackened stride, and smiles and nothing spoken, led on my merry guide. By blowing realms of woodland with sunstruck veins afield, and cloud-led shadows sailing about the windy weald, by valley-guarded granges and silver waters wide, content at heart I followed with my delightful guide. And like the cloudy shadows across the country blown, we two fare on forever, but not we two alone. With the great gale we journey, that breathes from gardens thinned, born in the drift of blossoms whose petals throng the wind. Buoyed on the heaven-heard whisper of dancing leaflets whirled, from all the woods that autumn bereaves in all the world. And midst the fluttering legion of all that ever died, I follow, and before us goes the delightful guide. With lips that brim with laughter, but never once respond, and feet that fly on feathers, and serpent-circled wand. 43. The immortal part. When I meet the morning beam, or lay me down at night to dream, I hear my bones within me say, another night, another day. When shall this slough of sense be cast, this dust of thought be laid at last, the man of flesh and soul be slain, and the man of bone remain? This tongue that talks, these lungs that shout, these thews that hustle us about, this brain that fills the skull with schemes, and its humming hive of dreams. These today are proud in power, and lord it in their little hour, the immortal bones obey control of dying flesh and dying soul. 'Tis long till eve and morn are gone, slowly endless night comes on, and late to fullness grows the birth that shall last as long as earth. Wanderers eastward, wanderers west, know you why you cannot rest. 'Tis that every mother's son travails with a skeleton. Lie down in the bed of dust, bear the fruit that bear you must. Bring the eternal seed to light, and morn is all the same as night. Rest you so from trouble sore, fear the heat, O sun, no more, nor the snowing winter wild, now you labour not with child. Empty vessel, garment cast, we that wore you long shall last, another night, another day, so my bones within me say. Therefore they shall not do my will, today, while I am master still, and flesh and soul, now both are strong, shall hail the sullen slaves along. Before this fire of sense decay, this smoke of thought blow clean away, and leave with ancient night alone the steadfast and enduring bone. 44. Shot? So quick, so clean an ending? Oh, that was right, lad, that was brave. Yours was not an ill for mending, 'twas best to take it to the grave. Oh, you had forethought, you could reason, and saw your road and where it led, and early wise and brave in season put the pistol to your head. Oh, soon, and better so than later, after long disgrace and scorn, you shot dead the household traitor, the soul that should not have been born. Right, you guessed the rising morrow, and scorn to tread the mire you must. Dust's your wages, son of sorrow, but men may come to worse than dust. Souls undone, undoing others, long time since the tale began. You would not live to wrong your brothers, O lad, you died as fits a man. Now to your grave shall friend and stranger, with ruth and some with envy come. Undishonoured, clear of danger, clean of guilt, pass hence and home. Turn safe to rest, no dreams, no waking, and here, man, here's the wreath I've made. 'Tis not a gift that's worth the taking, but wear it, and it will not fade. 45. If it chance your eye offend you, pluck it out, lad, and be sound. 'Twill hurt, but here are slaves to friend you, and many a balsam grows on ground. And if your hand or foot offend you, cut it off, lad, and be whole. But play the man, stand up and end you, when your sickness is your soul. 46. Bring, in this timeless grave to throw, no cypress, sombre on the snow. Snap not from the bitter yew, his leaves that live December through. Break no rosemary, bright with rhyme, and sparkling to the cruel clime. Nor plod the winter land to look for willows in the icy brook, to cast them leafless round him. Bring no spray that ever buds in spring. But if the Christmas field has kept awns the last greener overstepped, or shrivelled flax whose flower is blue, a single season never two, or if one holm whose year is o'er shivers on the upland floor, O bring from hill and stream and plain whatever will not flower again,
to give him comfort, he and those shall bide eternal bedfellows, and low upon the couch he lies, whence he never shall rise. 47. The Carpenter's Son. Here the hangman stops his cart, now the best friends must part. Fare you well, for ill fare I. Live, lads, and I will die. Oh, at home had I but stayed, pretence to my father's trade, had I stuck to plane and ads, had I not been lost, my lads, then I might have built, perhaps, gallows trees for other chaps, never dangled on my own, had I but left ill alone. Now, you see, they hang me high, and the people passing by stop to shake their fists and curse, so 'tis come from ill to worse. Here hang I, and right and left, two poor fellows hang for theft. All the same's the luck we prove, though the midmost hangs for love. Comrades all that stand and gaze, walk henceforth other ways. See my neck and save your own, comrades all, leave ill alone. Make some day a decent end, shrewder fellows than your friend. Fare you will, for ill fare I. Live, lads, and I will die. 48. Be still, my soul, be still. The arms you bear are brittle. Earth and high heaven are fixed of old and founded strong. Think, rather, call it thought, if now you grieve a little. The days when we had rest, O soul, for they were long. Men loved unkindness then, but lightless in the quarry. I slept and saw not, tears fell down, I did not mourn. Sweat ran and blood sprang out, and I was never sorry. Then it was well with me, in days ere I was born. Now, and I muse for why and never find the reason, I pace the earth and drink the air and feel the sun. Be still, my soul, it is but for a season. Let us endure an hour and see injustice done. Aye, look, high heaven and earth ail from the prime foundations. All thoughts to rive the heart are here, and all are vain. Horror and scorn and hate and fear and indignation. Oh, why did I awake? When shall I sleep again? 49. Think no more, lad. Laugh, be jolly. But why should men make haste to die? Empty heads and tongues are talking. Make the rough road easy walking. And the feather pate of folly bears the falling sky. Oh, 'tis jesting, dancing, drinking, spins the heavy world around. If young hearts were not so clever, oh, they would be young forever. Think no more, 'tis only thinking lays lads underground. 50. Clunton and Clunbury, Clungerford and Clun, are the quietest places under the sun. In valleys of springs of rivers, by Oney and Teme and Clun, the country for easy livers, the quietest under the sun. We still had sorrows to lighten, one could not always be glad, and lads knew trouble at Knighton, when I was a Knighton lad. By bridges that Thames run under, in London the town built ill, 'tis sure small matter for wonder, if sorrow is with one still. And if as a lad grows older, the troubles he bears are more, he carries his griefs on a shoulder, that handselled them long before. Where shall one halt to deliver this luggage I'd lief set down? Not Thames, nor Teme is the river, nor London, nor Knighton the town. 'Tis a long way further than Knighton, a quieter placer than Clun, where doomsday may thunder and lighten, and little 'twill matter to one. 51. Loitering with a vacant eye along the Grecian galley, and brooding on my heavy ill, I met a statue standing still. Still in marble stone stood he, and steadfastly he looked at me. Well met, I thought, the look would say. We both were fashioned far away. We neither knew, when we were young, these Londoners we live among. Still he stood and eyed me hard, an earnest and grave regard. What, lads, drooping with your lot? I too, be where I am not. I too survey that endless line of men whose thoughts are not as mine. Years, ere you stood up from rest, on my neck the collar pressed. Years, when you lay down your ill, I shall stand and bear it still. Courage, lads, 'tis not for long. Stand, quit you like stone, be strong. So I thought this look and would say, and light on me my trouble lay, and I stepped out in flesh and bone, manful like the man of stone. 52. Far in a western Brookland that bred me long ago, the poplars stand and tremble by pools I used to know. There, in the windless night time, the wanderer marvelling why, halts on the bridge to hearken how soft the poplars sigh. He hears, no more remembered, in fields where I was known, here I lie down in London and turn to rest alone. There, by the starlit fences, the wanderer halts and hears my soul that lingers sighing about the glimmering weirs. 53. The True Lover. The lad came to the door at night when lovers crown their vows and whistled soft and out of sight in shadows of the brows. I shall not vex you with my face, henceforth my love for A. So take me in your arms a space before the east is grey. When I from hence away am passed, I shall not find a bride, and you shall be the first and last I ever lay beside. She heard and went and knew not why, her heart to his she laid. Light was the air beneath the sky, but dark under the shade. Oh, do you breathe, lad, that you breast seems not to rise and fall, and here upon my bosom pressed these beats no heart at all. Oh, loud, my girl, it once would knock, you should have felt it then. But since for you I stopped the clock, it never goes again. Oh, lad, what is it, lad, that drips wet from your neck on mine? What is it falling on my lips, my lad, that tastes of brine? Oh, like enough 'tis blood, my dear, for when the knife has slit the throat across from ear to ear, 'twill bleed because of it. Under the stars the air was light, but dark below the boughs, the still air of speechless night, when lovers crown their vows. 54. With rue my heart is laden for golden friends I had, for many a rose-lipped maiden and many a footlight lad. By brooks too broad for leaping, the light-foot boys are laid, the rose-lipped girls are sleeping in fields where roses fade. 55. Westward on the high-hilled plains, where for me the world began, still, I think, in newer veins, frets the changeless blood of man. Now that other lads that I strip to bathe on Severn shore, they, no help for all they try, tread the mill I trod before. There, where hueless is the west, and the darkness hushes wide, where the lad lies down to rest, stands the troubled dream beside. There, on thoughts that once were mine, day looks down the eastern steep, and the youth that morning shine makes the vow he will not keep. 56. The Day of Battle. Far I hear the bugle blow to call me where I would not go, and the guns begin the song, soldier, fly or stay for long. Comrade, if to turn and fly made a soldier never die, fly I would, but who would not? 'Tis sure no pleasure to be shot. But since the man that runs away lives to die another day, and cowards' funerals when they come are not wept so well at home. Therefore, though the best is bad, stand and do my best, my lad. Stand and fight and see your slain, and take the bullet in your brain. 57. You smile upon your friend today. Today his ills are over. You hearten to the lovers say, and happy is the lover. 'Tis late to hearken, late to smile, but better late than never. I shall have lived a little while before I die for ever. 58. When I came last to Ludlow, amidst the moonlight pale, two friends kept step beside me, two honest lads and hale. Now Dick lies long in the churchyard, and Ned lies long in jail, and I come home to Ludlow, amidst the moonlit pale. 59. The Isle of Portland. The star-filled seas are smooth tonight, from France to England strown. Black towers above the Portland light, the felon quarried stone. On yonder islands not to rise, never to stir forth free, far from his folk a dead lad lies, that once was friends with me. Lie you easy, dream you light, and sleep you fast for aye, and luckier may you find the night than ever you found the day. 60. Now hollow fires burn out to black, and lights are guttering low. Square your shoulders, lift your pack, and leave your friends to go. Oh, never fear, man, naught to dread. Look not left nor right. In all the endless roads you tread, there's nothing but the night. 61. Hughley Steeple. The vane on Hughley Steeple veers bright a far-known sign, and there lie Hughley people, and there lie friends of mine. Tall in their midst the tower divides the shade and sun, and the clock strikes the hour and tells the time to none. To south the headstones cluster, the sunny mounds lie thick, the dead are more in muster at Hughley than the quick. North, for a soon-told number, chill graves the sexton delves, and steeple-shadowed slumber the slayers of themselves. To north, to south lie parted, with Hughley Tower above, the kind, the single-hearted, the lads I used to love. And south or north 'tis only a choice of friends one knows, and I shall ne'er be lonely, asleep with these or those. 62. Terence, this is stupid stuff. You eat your victuals fast. There can't be much amiss, 'tis clear, to see the rate you drink your beer. But oh, good Lord, the verse you make, it gives a chap the bellyache. The cow, the old cow, she is dead. It sleeps well, the horned head. We poor lads, 'tis our turn now to hear such tunes as killed the cow. Pretty friendship, 'tis to rhyme your friends to death before their time. Moping, melancholy, mad, come, pipe a tune to dance to, lad. Why, if 'tis dancing you would be, there's brisker pipes than poetry. Say, for what were hopyards meant, or why was Burton built on Trent? Oh, many a peer of England brews livelier liquor than the muse, and malt does more than Milton can to justify God's way to man. Ale, man, ale's the stuff to drink for fellows whom it hurts to think. Look into the pewter pot to see the world as the world's not. And faith, 'tis pleasant till 'tis past. The mischief is, 'twill not last. Oh, I have been to Ludlow Fair, and left my necktie God knows where, and carried halfway home or near pints and quarts of Ludlow beer. Then the world seemed none so bad, and I myself a sterling lad, and down in lovely muck I've lain, happy till I woke again. Then I saw the morning sky. Hey-ho, the tale was all a lie. The world, it was the old world yet. I was I, my things were wet, and nothing now remained to do but begin the game anew. Therefore, since the world has still much good, but much less good than ill, and while the sun and moon endure, luck's a chance, but trouble's sure, I'd face it as a wise man would, and train for ill and not for good. 'Tis true, the stuff I bring for sale is not so brisk a brew as ale. Out of a stem that scored the hand, I wrung it in a weary land. But take it, if the smack is sour, the better for the embittered hour. It should do good to heart and head, when your soul is in my soul's stead. And I will friend you, if I may, in the dark and cloudy day. There was a king reigned in the east, there, when kings will sit to feast, they get their fill before they think, with poisoned meat and poisoned drink. He gathered all that springs to birth from the many venomed earth. First a little, thence to more, he sampled all her killing store, and easy smiling season's sound sate the king when healths went round. They put arsenic in his meat, and stared aghast to watch him eat. They poured strychnine in his cup, and shook to see him drink it up. They shook, they stared, as white's their shirt. Them it was their poison hurt. I tell the tale that I heard told. Mithridates, he died old. 63. I hoed and trenched and weeded, and took the flowers to fair. I brought them home unheeded. The hue was not the wear. So up and down I sow them, for lads like me to find, when I shall lie below them, a dead man out of mind. Some seed the birds devour, and some the season mars, but here and there will flower the solitary stars, and fields will yearly bear them, as light leaves spring comes on, and luckless lads will wear them when I am dead and gone.